Hey everyone, in this video we're going to talk about how to graph a parabola, graph a quadratic function here, okay? And there's multiple ways of doing it, but the simplest, most straightforward way of doing it is to identify some key attributes. The first one is identifying the axis of symmetry and then using that to find the vertex. So the first thing we're going to do is find our axis of symmetry. And if you remember, the formula for the axis of symmetry is x equals negative b over 2a. So we need, in order to do this, we need to identify our a value, our b value, and our c value. So just like always, our a value is the coefficient in front of the x squared, so that'd be negative 2. Our b value is the coefficient in front of the x, so that'd be 16. And our c value is the constant at the end. Now, the c value doesn't matter in this particular problem, but it would if we're using a different formula. So from here, we're just going to substitute. So we got negative parentheses 16 over 2 times a, which is negative 2. And then we can simplify that. That becomes negative 16 over negative 4, which is 4. So our axis of symmetry is x equals 4. Now, if that was the question, what is the axis of symmetry? And you just said the answer is 4. That is technically not correct. The axis of symmetry is a line, and that line is a vertical line at x equals 4, which means we're going to go to the right 4 and then draw a line there, okay? So we need to make sure that we're writing this appropriately. So our axis of symmetry is x equals 4. The next thing we have to do is identify the vertex. Well, we already have half of the vertex. We have the x value for the vertex. Now we need to find the y value. So we're just going to plug this x equals 4 back into the function. So this will say y equals negative 2 parentheses 4 squared plus 16 parentheses 4 minus 25. Then using our order of operations, we're going to do the exponents first. So it'll be negative 2 times 16 because 4 squared is 16. And then we'll carry everything else down. And then we'll do our multiplication. Negative 2 times 16 is negative 32. 16 times 4 is 64, and then the minus 25. Negative 32 plus 64 is positive 32, minus 25 is 7. So our vertex, remember, is the point at which the parabola changes direction. And so we have to write it as a coordinate. The vertex here is going to be 4, comma 7. That is our vertex, okay? Now, another interesting point, another important point on a graph is the y-intercept. Now, we are trained to recognize that the y-intercept is the last term after we get rid of all the x terms. The reason that is the case is because the y-intercept is where the graph crosses that y-axis. Well, that coordinate is going to be over 0 and then up or down, whatever we need to go to get to that point. So usually the c-term is the y-value of the y-intercept, but we need to write it as a coordinate. It's 0, negative 25. So if you're not writing the y-intercept as a coordinate, you're going to be getting that wrong on some sort of test. If you just put y equals negative 25 or negative 25, that is not correct. That is the y-value for the y-intercept, but the y-intercept also includes an x-value of 0. Okay. Now, let's get to graphing this. Now that we know the vertex, and we know the y-intercept, and we know something else about the a value, we can graph this a little bit easier. So in fact, let me go ahead and erase all of this here, and I'm just going to rewrite the vertex up above so I have more room on my board. So we know that the vertex was 4, 7, and we know that the y-intercept is 0, negative 25. Now, I'm not going to graph it far enough to see the y-intercept, but hopefully we can see the connection there, okay? So, setting up my coordinate grid, we're going to go to the right 4 and up 7, and we're going to put a point, 4, 7. There's my vertex. Now, the next thing we have to ask ourselves is whether this parabola opens up or opens down. We know that this parabola opens down because the a value is negative. A value is less than 0. A value is negative. So we know it's going to open down. The next thing we have to look for is our slope pattern or our graphing pattern, however you want to look at that. okay? However you want to say that, the slope pattern. Remember, normally when A is 1, when we don't really have a coefficient out front other than 1, our slope pattern is 1 over 1, 4 over 2, and 9 over 3, and then so on and so forth. But because the A value is negative 2, we're going to take that original slope pattern and multiply all of these by negative 2, okay? So from here, we would get negative 2 over 1, negative 8 over 2, and negative 18 over 3. Now, I realize that these can be reduced, but I don't want to because this is going to be a slope. It's going to tell me to go down 8 and to the right 2, okay? So our first movement is down 2 to the right 1, so down 2 and right 1. Our next movement from the vertex, we always start from the vertex, is down 8 and over 2. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 over 2. So it's going to be like this. And then the next one will be down 18. So that's going to be way down here. I'm not going to graph that one. From here, we're going to reflect all those points. So instead of going down to right 1, we're going to go down to back 1. And then down 8, back 2. And so now I have a pretty good amount of points that I can get an idea of what this parabola looks like. Now, I'm not too picky on how perfect your parabola is, but I am pretty picky on identifying those key points, okay? I want to see all those points in that graph. I think that would be ideal, okay? Now, we can check to make sure that this makes sense by looking at our y-intercept. Our y-intercept says 0, negative 25, so that means I would go down 25, which is way down there, and that makes sense because I haven't hit the y-axis yet, and so as I move a little bit closer and closer, I'm going to get there eventually, okay? So that is how you graph a parabola. First, start off finding your axis of symmetry. Then use your axis of symmetry, plug that into the x's here to find the y value of your vertex. Then you have your vertex. You do the slope pattern, your normal slope pattern, 1 over 1, 4 over 2, 9 over 3, and multiplying that by whatever your a value is. That's the thing that's going to stretch it out or shrink it, okay? If the a value is just 1, then you just plot those patterns. And then from there, you check your work by looking at your y-intercept and making sure it makes sense, okay? If you have any questions on this, please reach out by commenting below or finding me in tutoring. I will talk to you all later.